Assalamu alaikum. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah. Ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu ala ba'd. Our brothers and sisters, it is the easiest thing in me in the world to invite Imam Mohammed, and I'll tell you why. It's very easy for me. In 1975, with the death of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, his son, our beloved speaker tonight, Imam Mohammed, took over the nation of Islam. He already knew Islam. We didn't. And Allah gave him wisdom to come in a community who thought they knew Islam. It was in 1975, Imam Muhammad introduced me to Al-Quran. It was in 1975, Imam Muhammad introduced me to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the rest of us. Imam, we loved you, and we're very, very honored to have you in our first conference. Welcome, Imam Wahhaj Muhammad.
Peace be unto you all. Assalamu alaikum. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalamu ala Rasulihi al-Kareem Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a beautiful sight I'm looking at. This is wonderful. And I'm going to let out a little secret here, right now, on the game. Imam Siraj Wahhaj came to me after some time being in pain and seeing where we had to go, and he didn't want to hang around until I brought everybody up to where we should be. So he came to me just like a brother, and he said, "But Imam, you are this, you are that." Wonderful compliments. And he said, "But I have to leave." And I said, in a few words, I said, "Go in peace." And you had my support to leave. I didn't tell you this. I was happy to see you leave. For more than one reason. But mainly to see you free. To see you free, my brother. And I'm glad that Allah has blessed you to find your way to where you have to be. And I'm with you. I'm your follower as well as you are my follower. Yes. I have a plane to catch and an urgent matters back home backing up on me. So I won't be with you long here. Maybe 20 to 30 minutes at the most. But I would like to speak to the theme and also to the question, to the theme for the panel also. The theme is the state of Black American Muslim community, the state of the Black American Muslim community. And for the panel, envisioning our future, envisioning our future. Islamic knowledge is growing in Black America, among the Muslims, all of us. Islamic knowledge is growing among us, and it's growing for the whole America, for the whole of this America. This knowledge is growing for all of us, and we benefit from the advances that each of us as separate groups make in the path of Allah. As we progress in the path of Allah, we strengthen each other because we are all in the context of the geography we call the United States of America. And as we can all be in the mind and spirit to appreciate each other, as workers in the path of God, vis-a-vis-a-dai, who appreciate Islamic knowledge, coming firstly from his book, Allah's book, the Quran, and secondly, from the traditional life of our Prophet Muhammad, upon him be the prayers and the peace. If we all agree there, then we should be able to get support for our souls and spirit from the advances that each of we separately are making in the path of God. So I pray Allah that we will live to see it become a reality, this alliance of Muslim groups in America. We are told by God to push forward, press forward, to advance ourselves, struggle. And we are also told to form alliances. Jahidu wa rawabitu. Make the effort strong for progress and form alliances. So I support what you're all about 100%. Yes. Also, more and more, the lives of Black American Muslims will come under the influence of Islamic knowledge and Islamic spirit. Islamic knowledge carries with it a spirit. All knowledge, in fact, once it reaches our minds, it brings to us also a spirit, an influence. A spirit is an influence. It brings to us a spirit. A spirit of the word. As we accept Islamic knowledge and grow in Islamic knowledge, that knowledge also grow us in spirit, which is extremely important, that we be in the spirit of Islam. Not only have knowledge, but be in the spirit of Islam. The holdback is a tendency in the waters of Black America, a tendency in our sensitivities as Black Americans to be given to mood swings and trendy lifestyles. Islamic knowledge is guiding and influencing our sensitivities for our community future. So I see us having a bright and great future, but that future depends on us recognizing that the Quran is not just a book of faith, it's a book of guidance. It's a book of knowledge. It's a book of guidance with also analysis for all of our situations, for all of our problems, for our emotional states that we're in, that are presenting great trouble to us over these many generations that we've been here in America. But Islamic knowledge and Islamic analysis for such situations is what will save us for the future and give us a great and bright future. And we are growing, I know that. I know, my brother, you have grown over the many years. And you know me, Elijah's son has grown too, hasn't he? So we are growing in Islamic knowledge. It's the Quran. The Quran was planted in our midst. The Quran came as a thief in the night. It was planted in our midst, came as a thief in the night because we didn't recognize what its purpose was until it had already taken effect. And it came to steal us back for our heritage. Most of the Africans brought to these shores were brought from Islamic culture, not from Christian culture and not from ancestor worship. We were brought from Islam. Their history record tells us that. We were brought from Islamic. At one point, the Christian Society of America got knowledge that they had brought some Christians in as slaves. And the establishment was told, you cannot bring Christians in as slaves. You cannot enslave a Christian. So if they could not enslave a Christian, who were they enslaving? Muslims. Islam is not only the heritage of the Muslims that are known to be Muslims, like myself and you and the people, many who are African-American Muslims belonging to different groups in this country. No, it is also the heritage of those who call themselves Christian and don't know that their heritage is not Christianity, their heritage is Islam. Thank you very much. Assalamu alaikum. May God guide us always and show us mercy. Ameen.